We'll be driven by facts, we'll be driven by evidence, we'll be driven by science.
And science tells us is that we must have testing, testing, testing.
Everyone says they are guided by science. On May 13th, Mayor Erik Garcetti said that California's largest city, Los Angeles, would never be completely reopened until there is a vaccine. With deficits and unemployment rising in the nation's most populous state, we thought we should take a closer look at what some of the stats have to say. First, let's look at this chart. This is directly from the CDC website, tracking and projecting all deaths in California by all causes from January 2017 through April 2020. It varies, but roughly 750 people die every day from all causes in California. But notice where the spike is. January 2018, right around one of the worst flu seasons in recent history. But what about the last 3 months with the outbreak of COVID-19? As of May 12th, California was reporting approximately 2,800 COVID-19 deaths, while the CDC was reporting 1,800, plus another 1,000 from reported pneumonia COVID-19 combinations. Which begs a vital question of, how are these cases being reported? Now, let's start to bring this home. 3/4 of the population of California is under 55. That's about 29 million people. And of those 29 million people under 55, according to CDC information from February 1st to May 10th, 97 die every day on average for any reason, regardless of COVID-19. So that essentially puts your odds of dying on any given day at around 1 in 300,000 from any cause. Now, based on current California COVID data over the last 3 months, approximately 3 people under 55 have died each day, on average, from COVID-19 specifically, putting these odds at around 1 in 9 million and increasing just slightly each day. Now, to be fair, this is data collected during a quarantine, so if we lifted it, the risk would certainly go up. But the question is, how much more? Also, none of this data factors in that the vast majority of people who have died from COVID-19 have had pre-existing conditions. Now, it's true we don't know the lifetime risk of COVID-19 because it's so new, but for a rough comparison, let's just look at the number of deaths from motor vehicle accidents in California. Roughly 7 people under the age of 55 die every single day from a car crash, and yet we keep driving. Now, to be fair, car crashes aren't contagious and they don't exponentially spread like a virus, so it's not an apples-to-apples comparison, but it is food for thought. COVID-19 is a real and terrible thing that has happened, but the US economy is facing unprecedented damage, skyrocketing unemployment, and the destruction of lives. The question now is not what we should have done, no one could have predicted this accurately, but rather, what do we do now? When the stats are left to speak for themselves, they may tell a very different story than the media and many of our government leaders are willing to let us believe. Please become one of our statistics and subscribe to Minute Stats today. Help us keep creating responsible media.